In this lecture, we will discuss about functional form specification, test for linearity, test for linearity based on Box-Cox transformation. In this class, I will start my discussion with functional form specification. We have already discussed adapting incorrect functional form. So, for example, if we estimate a linear model yi equal to beta 1 plus beta 2 x2 I plus beta 3 x3 I plus e y, but the true model is of a log linear type, log yi equal to log yi equal to b1 plus beta 1 log xi x2 I plus beta 3 log x3 I plus e y. Then the misspecification arises because we estimate the wrong functional form. A related question is, while estimating the regression equation, we have assumed linear specification, but in reality, we may encounter the case of nonlinearity. Thus, we need to test for the assumption of linearity. Let us then discuss the test for linearity. One of the assumptions made in the regression model is the assumption of linearity, but in reality, the assumption of linearity may not be satisfied always. The nonlinearity of the system can be of two types. First of all, the equation may be nonlinear in variables, or the equation is nonlinear in parameter. If the model is nonlinear in variables, it does not cause much problem because by suitable transformation, we can convert this model into a linear one. But if the model is nonlinear in parameter, then it really causes estimation problem because in those cases, we have to think alternative method of estimation than ordinary regression method, which in turn depends on the assumed model specification. So, let us discuss the concept of intrinsically linear model. A model is intrinsically linear if, as indicated, nonlinear with respect to the variable. The common characteristics of such model is that they can be converted into ordinary linear model by a suitable transformation of the variable. So, intrinsically linear model are those model for which we can convert it into a linear model by some suitable transformation. Now, let us take some example. As a first case, we take the model in which the regressors are represented by the power series of xi. So, yi equal to b1 plus b2 xi plus b3 xi square plus bk xki whole to the power k minus 1 plus ei, where xi is non-stochastic and bounded, and ei is the distribution term that satisfies all the assumption of classical linear regression model. But whatever the degree of polynomial in relation A, the equation can be written as yi equal to b1 plus b2 xi plus b3 zi plus bk zki plus ei, where z3i equal to xi square, similarly zki equal to xi whole to the power k minus 1. Now, if the number of observation exceeds k, the ordinary least square estimator of the regression coefficient will have the desirable property. However, the z's will often be highly correlated, so that the variance of the estimator of this regression coefficient may be quite large. Now, one nice feature of the power function of the equation A or its equivalent B is that we can easily test the hypothesis that degree of polynomial is less than k minus 1. This can be done by testing the null hypothesis beta 3 equal to beta 4 up to beta k equal to 0 and H1 stating that H0 is not true. General test procedure. The general test procedure can be described as follows. Consider two competing theory. One states that yi equal to b1 plus beta 2 x2i plus beta 3 x3i up to beta k xki plus ei, And the other theory tells that y depends not only on x2, x3 up to xk, but also on the additional explanatory variable like xk plus 1 up to xkq, where q is greater than k. So one can write yi equal to b1 plus beta 2 x2 I plus beta 3 x3 I plus beta k xk I plus beta k plus 1 xk plus 1 up to beta q xq plus ei. In this case, the second theory can be tested by testing h0 beta k plus 1 equal to beta k plus 2 up to beta q equal to 0 against the alternative hypothesis that h0 is not true. To formulate this test, we introduce a new notation. Subscript k denote the values pertaining to the original set of explanatory variable, and subscript q denote the values to the extended set of the explanatory variable. Let SST equal to total sum of square, SSR equal to residual sum of square, SSE equal to explained sum of square. Therefore, SST equal to SSR k plus SSEK. Similarly, SSTQ equal to SSRQ plus SSEQ. That is, total sum of square equal to the residual sum of square plus explained sum of square. This will be true both for the explanatory variable q as well as for the explanatory variable k. Now, if the additional explanatory variables are not relevant in explaining the variation of y, then the population SSRK and SSRQ would be same, and observed difference between them would be entirely due to the sampling error. In this case, it can be shown that under H0, F is equal to F3 by F4, and which is distributed as F distribution with FQ minus K and NQ minus degrees of freedom, where F3 is defined as SSRQ minus SSEK whole divided by Q minus K, and F4 equal to SSEQ by N minus Q. This can be used to test H0 at a specified level of significance. So, we will basically test whether F follows a F distribution with FQ minus K and N minus Q degrees of freedom. Now, let us consider some example. Consider now a regression equation in which changes in expected value of y corresponding to a unit change in x2 depends on xk. Let us denote expected value of yi as a function of x2i and x3i. So, partial derivative of expected value of yi with respect to x2i depends on x3. And let us denote this as g of x3i. Similarly, partial derivative of expected value of yi with respect to x3i will depend on x2i, and let us denote this as h x2i, where g x3i and h x2i are some function of the mathematical form specified a priori. There are many situations in which such model is appropriate. For example, in estimation of angle curve from the cross-section data, the family of expenditure on a given commodity is frequently considered to be dependent on both family income as well as family size. So, it may be reasonable to expect that families of different sizes respond to a given changes in income in different way. Similarly, the families to different income bracket respond to differently to a changes in family size. So, the simplest formulation of such model is obtained by introducing what is called an interaction term. So, let us denote yi equal to beta 1 plus beta 2 x2i plus beta 3 x3i plus beta 4 x2i x3i plus ei. Denote x4 as x2i multiplied by x3i. Thus, the model is said to be intrinsically linear. Here, partial derivative of expected value of yi with respect to x2i will be equal to b2 plus b4 x3i. Similarly, partial derivative of expected value of yi with respect to x3i will be equal to b3 plus b4 x2i. So, these are some implications for test of hypothesis. When there are interaction terms in the equation, then any given explanatory variable may be represented not by one but by several regression. The hypothesis that this variable does not influence expected value of y means that coefficient of the regression involving this variable are jointly zero. Therefore, the appropriate test will be an F test. In order to test x2i equal to 0, we should jointly test b2 equal to b4, that is equal to 0. Now, let us then discuss another test for linearity, which is based on Box-Cox transformation. Now, the basic idea of this test rests on the fact that linear function is a special case of a power function, namely power function of some degree 1. If the coefficient attached to the higher power function of the explanatory variable are all 0, the power function reduces to a simple linear regression model. This idea can be exploited by specifying other functional form which include linearity as a special case. Particularly suitable for this purpose is the Box-Cox transformation defined as follows. Where yi whole to the power lambda is equal to yi whole to the power lambda minus 1 whole divided by lambda if lambda is not equal to 0 and log of yi if lambda is equal to 0. Therefore, instead of regressing y on x, we basically regress this power function of y on such similar power function of x. This means that for lambda equal to 0 and for xi and yi positive, the regression reduces to log yi equal to a plus b log xi plus ei. For lambda equal to 1, we obtain yi minus 1 equal to a plus b xi minus 1 plus ei or yi equal to a star plus b xi plus ei, where a star is defined as a minus b plus 1. Thus, for lambda equal to 0, we have a log-linear specification and for lambda equal to 1, we have a linear specification. In general, different values of lambda leads to different functional specification of the regression equation. This fact allows us to test the linear hypothesis against the alternative hypothesis that regression equation is some linear function within the family of function defined by such transformation incorporating lambda. Formally, we can test lambda equal to 1 against the alternative hypothesis H0 is equal to true. Because lambda is equal to 1 basically implies we have a case of linear specification. Now, to carry out the test, we need to estimate lambda and its standard error. Clearly, lambda can be estimated along with the other parameter by maximum likelihood method. In setting the likelihood function for y1, y2 up to yn, we have to derive the distribution of y's from the distribution of e's. For this, we need Jacobian of transformation dei divided by dyi, which is equal to yi whole to the power lambda minus 1. Thus, Jacobian of transformation in this case depends on lambda. In other words, this basically implies the likelihood function also depends on the Jacobian of transformation lambda. To make the likelihood function free from Jacobian of transformation, we can divide the sample value of y by the geometric mean of y. So, let us divide the sample value of y by the geometric mean of y. Such a scaling leaves the parameter lambda unaffected, but the intercept and the slope will now have different interpretation. The likelihood function can be maximized for a range of value of lambda. We will choose that value of lambda that maximizes the likelihood function, say lambda star. Once the maximum likelihood estimates have been found, we can use the likelihood ratio test for linearity. The test statistics for large sample test is then given as LR equal to minus 2 times L of lambda equal to 1 minus L of lambda star, which is distributed as a chi-square with 1 degree of freedom. Where lambda is equal to 1 is equal to the maximum value of L for linear regression model, and L star is equal to the maximum value of L when lambda is set equal to its maximum likelihood value. So, by using this likelihood ratio test, we can test whether lambda is equal to 1. In other words, we can test whether the model fits linear specification. In this lecture, we have discussed about functional form misspecification, some test for linearity, and also the test for linearity based on Boxcox transformation.